So tell us about what actions have been drafted, and I suppose the efficacy, given that we know the government is already under sanctions after the election.
Yeah, I mean, the EU's actually acted pretty swiftly by its own standards. It's it was just gone 10 o'clock tonight in Brussels when they agreed the package, which was more or less in line with the draft that they'd gone in with at the start of the dinner 3 hours earlier. It basically involves a new round of sanctions, as you say, which is going to target businesses from wider sectors of the economy, and we've been told potentially people close to President Lukashenko. And then there's going to be also restrictions on flights across and from Belarus. So EU-based airlines have been asked not to fly across Belarus, and Belarus's airline, the national carrier, has been banned from entering EU airspace as well. So it's a relatively full package of measures.
Yeah, we also heard from Air France saying that they will suspend flights over Belarus. But all of these sanctions, how do they play in with the fact that Russia, for example, has its weight behind Lukashenko?
Well, there's limits to what the EU can hope to expect with this. While Putin is supporting Lukashenko, you're dead right about that. There was actually one concern that was expressed. You know, we heard earlier on in the day that maybe sanctions would risk pushing Belarus closer to Putin, and I think that in the final calculation, probably they've decided that. Lukashenko is pretty much dependent on Putin already, so they don't need to worry about that. That is the question: is, you know, how you go about prising away that regime from its Kremlin sponsors is a terribly tricky challenge for the EU, and you know, matches up the kind of the related challenges they see across their eastern borders, where Putin's influence is obviously extensive.